boats because I grew up sailing in Melch's MC Scout, which is a lake boat. Melch's is based out of Zenda, Wisconsin, which is kind of in the middle of nowhere, but they do have Lake Geneva just nearby, which is how they kind of got into lake sailing. But they do make some ocean-going boats. Specifically, I did an analysis of all their racing boats, and their scouts range from 16 feet to 38 feet, and their sports boats go from 20 to 38 feet. What this means is they kind of have a huge white space where anything above 38 feet, they don't even address that market. So with a 50-foot sailboat, this would almost be twice the size of their current boat. Melch's also has a very rich racing history with Buddy Melch's, who won the America's Cup in 1992, which is actually designed by the same designer that makes all their boats for them at Melch's. So essentially, they're just stacked with racing history and heritage. But the big downside about the company is most of their boats, specifically the scouts, you cannot live inside them. It's like a scout, which is this boat up here, is kind of like a giant oversized windsurfing boat where there's not even a cabin. You can't even go inside of it. So with their sports boats, you actually can go inside of them, but most of those are being utilized for professional racing or semi-professional racing. Basically, companies that have a lot of money or people that have a lot of money that want to go out and do this as a hobby on the weekend and have a group of friends with it do this. So I would classify Melch's boats, this is kind of mean, but in the affordable racing category. It's people on a budget or racing on a budget. It's not people with unlimited funds, it's not huge massive companies. But huge massive companies have realized that this is a market and they've started to address that. Specifically with the Melch's 20, which was they actually designed for Audi. So Audi has a racing series where you can just go out there, buy this boat, put together a team, and you can go race it. Most of Melch's boats are considered, or actually not considered, but they are one design boats, which means you buy them and you can't modify them from that point in order to be eligible into the racing series. So I did some initial quick concept sketches and kind of moved on to some packaging concepts. The big thing that I noticed that with a sailboat is one, it takes manpower to operate. It takes a lot of crew in order to even have the boat function. It's not like a motorboat where you can go hop on with one person, technically take it from point A to point B. The reason for that is because you have to adjust all the sails and it just takes people to run all those winches and lines. So specifically, if I wanted to make the boat more of a live aboard boat where people actually kind of live on the boat or take it around the world, I designed the boat to have a much larger superstructure so that you could actually have a lot of room and enjoy it inside. And then all the way down to a racing boat, which is almost minimal superstructure, because most of the time you're actually working on the boat when it's in operation. You're not really enjoying the inside view very much because it's going to be really cramped. And it's designed for only one purpose, to go fast. One thing that I know from my past in sailing boats is the front foredeck is really important because usually you have a person up there on the foredeck crew going from side to side, back and forth, as the boat tacks back and forth. Another thing that I always notice is that the windows are usually really high and really small on sailboats, specifically because they're when they're on starboard or port tack. The water line can come up almost to this point and you don't want to have your windows underwater. So I took one of these concepts and thought, what could it be if it was actually taken and turned into a race boat? So that's kind of what I'm thinking about right now, and the direction that I'm heading. But what I want to do is kind of create a boat that both respects their sailing heritage, but also takes them into a new direction, because right now all they do is racing. And I think if it's just a race boat, that's obviously too limiting. So I want to find that happy medium, which is kind of almost a hybrid boat, something that you could live aboard, where you could take, you know, with just a few friends, you could sail it from port to port, or maybe even, you know, across the ocean and have an enjoyable time. But also, once you're there, you could actually go and race it and actually do fairly well. So that's kind of the direction I'm leaning. Thank you very much.
Great. Okay. Yes, I agree with you completely in the direction to take it. That it's a racer cruiser, not a cruiser racer, a racer cruiser, right? Racing is the primary function, but yeah, if it's doing a transat or something, a transat, you know, okay, doing that, or you know, they just have to deliver it to somewhere and they're participating. Do you think one design, you know, really respecting Melch's and they have such a strong one design?
So the smaller boats are typically one design, and that's because of cost. As you get larger, you compete in such as the Transpac or, you know,
but you know, is it like, you know, it's kind of the Volvo 60, but it's not, it's this other thing, or it's like a far Yes.
I would say it probably won't be a one design. I would say it's probably just, it would just have a length. It would get a PHRF rating, which means it can compete against other boats. And PHRF rating, do you know what that is? Okay. So it's basically like a handicap in golf. So you can compete against other boats, even 60s or 40s. And depending on your time, you can still be competitive. I think it fits more into that category.
Okay, fair enough. I think that's good. So at this size now, who do you think is your biggest competitor that's out there?
Obviously, as you already said, FAR. The Volvo 60s are, you know, those are...
How about a manufacturer who makes up in this size? You know, 50s. 50 to 55.
There's a lot of other boat manufacturers in there, but it's almost in the cost range.
Yeah, how about, can you think of one that's doing...
I was going to mention one, I would say, there are FAR 40s, which are a little bit under that. I think there is a FAR 60, and I don't know if they have a 48 or somewhere in there.
What I'm thinking is J-boats.
J-boats, yeah, that's like the J-30s and stuff
right.
like that.
Because they have the same... A similar kind of history,
yes.
But now I mean they do what they or they have, you know, like a J63 or something,
yes.
Okay. Right. So I think that's the market that you're entering.
Okay.
So I think it'd be great to do a bunch of research on
okay.
J-boats at this size
yep.
or similar size range. You just have to understand what they've done because they've really cornered the market in branding themselves as you know fast,
yes.
ultra capable yep. boats, but they're still very little.
Yeah.
And I think that's a great direction because they do have such a huge share of the market. Meldrum's approaching that and doing it perfect.
Thank you.
Good, very good.